diaphragm. It is a fibromuscular partition which separating the thoracic cavity from the abdominal cavity. Origin of the diaphragm from the whole circumference of the inner aspect of the thoracic outlet. It takes origin from three areas. Number one, sternal origin from the back of the void process by two slips. Costal origin from the inner surface of the lower six costal cartilages. Vertebral origin by two crura, right cross and left cross, and the arcuate ligaments. The right cross arises from the size of the upper three lumbar vertebrae and contains the esophageal opening, and it is larger than the left cross. Number two, left cross, it is smaller and rises from the size of the upper two lumbar vertebrae. Insertion of diaphragm. All fibers of diaphragm are inserted into the central tendon. This tendon is a strong aponeurosis, semilunar in shape, and formed by one median loop and two lateral loops. The median loop is related to the pericardium and the heart. Action of diaphragm, it is the chief muscle of respiration. Number two, it is used to increase the intra-abdominal pressure. The red cross acts as a sphincter to the esophagus. This is the diaphragm, origin of diaphragm, from costal cartilages, from vertebral column, right and the left cross, inserted into the central tendon. The ligaments of diaphragm, number one, medial arcuate ligament, one on each side, extends from the cross of diaphragm to the tip of the transverse processes of the first lumbar vertebra. It reaches over the psoas major muscle. Lateral arcuate ligament, one on each side, extends from the tip of transverse process of the first lumbar vertebra to the last rib. It reaches over the quadratus lumborum muscle. The median arcuate ligament, one only, lies on the median plane, extends between the right and the left crura. It arches over the aorta. This is the ligaments. This is the medial arcuate ligament, the lateral arcuate ligament, and this is the median arcuate ligament. The major openings of the diaphragm, number one, aortic opening in the median plane behind the median arcuate ligament at the level of the last thoracic vertebra. It transmits the aorta on the left side, azygos vein to the right side, thoracic duct in between aorta and azygos vein. Number two, esophageal opening lies within the right cross, 1 inch to the left of the median plane at the level of the 10th thoracic vertebra. It transmits esophagus, anterior gastric nerve, which is continuation of the left vagus, posterior gastric nerve, which is a continuation of the right vagus. The third opening, vena cava opening, lies within the central tendon, 1 inch to the right of the median plane at the level of the 8th thoracic vertebra. It transmits the inferior vena cava and the right phrenic nerve. This is the opening of the diaphragm. This is her esophageal opening. And this is aortic opening. And this is vena cava opening in the central tendon. The minor openings of diaphragm, number one, between the sternal and the costal origins of diaphragm, superior epigastric artery passes to enter the rectus sheath. Number two, between digitations of the costal origin, passes the lower five intercostal nerves and vessels. Between the slips of origin of the diaphragm from 7th to 8th costal cartilages. Basis musculophrenic artery. Number 4, behind the lateral arcuate ligament passes subcostal nerve and vessels. Number 5, behind the medial arcuate ligament passes the sympathetic trunk. Number 6, greater and lesser splanchnic nerves pierces the crust of the corresponding side. Number 7, hemiazygous vein pierces the left crust to enter the thorax. Number 8 and last one, left phrenic nerve pierces the left cupula of the diaphragm. This is the minor openings for the diaphragm, the blood and nerve supply of diaphragm. Number one, arterial supply of diaphragm comes from the following. Number one, pericardiacophrenic artery from the internal thoracic or internal mammary. Musculophrenic also from the internal thoracic. Superior phrenic from the thoracic aorta. Inferior phrenic from the abdominal aorta. Lower intercostals from the thoracic aorta. The nerve supply, right and left phrenic nerves from cervical third, fourth, and fifth cervical nerves, arises in the cervical region and descends to supply the inferior surface of the diaphragm, in addition to the lower six intercostal nerves to supply peripheral part of the diaphragm as sensor. This is the arterial supply here, phrenic arteries, and this is phrenic nerves to supply the abdominal surface